Descend, faithful. We depart.
Never wanted the easy path.
The moment comes. Absolute moves. Descend, assemble.
Seems
obey.
Still breathing, despite everything.
Not design, but death. Assemble.
A whole fleet of Nautiloids. How many true souls have passed through this place? No longer a background murmur, the presence in your mind builds to a roar.
We found it. The Absolute is behind this door.
No longer a background murmur, the
There's no time to waste.
No longer.
You said it was under control.
It isn't you I answer to, Gortash.
Oh, the general voice. Is this where we salute?
Salute, yes. With cleavers through his blood-starved flesh. How it crawls with failure, like flies on lick-wet carrion.
You forget yourself, Auron. I have played my part.
You've built an army for our masters, true enough, but what of the Astral Prison? A rogue true soul flaunting it under your nose all this time, and you ran from her.
Sure that they would follow and deliver it into my hands here. If you would cease these distractions.
The distractions have been yours, Ketherick. Perhaps we never should have dug your daughter up. So you haven't lost your edge, but you're still not as sharp as Auron, I wager.
His crypt breath sings to my sinews again, 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 again. But he must lead the murder march to Baldur's grave.
If the weapon is truly in your grasp, Ketherick, might I suggest closing your fist? Auron and I can wait for you no longer. The plan proceeds. We're going to the city, and we expect you to follow. Army and the weapon in tow. The Edict of Bane!
The Lash of Baal! One of the cruelest and most powerful creatures in existence, enslaved by mere mortals.
Look at that crown. It radiates with power unlike anything I've ever seen. To have it, to hold. Oh, if only I could, but I can't. This is it. I must do as Mistra commands. What choice do I have? More than just a goddess counts with my courage. Whole worlds hang in the balance.
I do trust you. More than myself right now. Perhaps even more than Mistra.
I have no desire to end your life, you know that. To end it? To struggle on? It is a grave choice you're making for us both. But if it must be so, very well. I'll stand down to stand by you.
There we are. It wouldn't do to fight in front of our guests. Behold, Duke Ravengard, the Absolute.
Home, preserve us.
You wag your word flap in vain, Alderling. Once the worm holds the whip, your shredded flesh will serve us.
Now, it's really time we were going. We will empty this place and begin the march. You may catch up with the army once you've retrieved the weapon. And Ketherick, do try not to sulk. You're supposed to be the fearsome general come to conquer the city. And I am the hero who will save it.
It is time, faithful ones. march on Baldur's Gate. We go to prepare the way.
Blackets will be done. Without delay.
There you are. As predicted. What is it, I wonder, that draws one toward death like a moth to light? You could have run away. Absconded with the prism. The one thing that could prevent me from fulfilling my destiny. But the lure of one's destiny is irresistible, isn't it? Perhaps you hope to learn your place in history before you are erased from it. A bright flash of clarity before the snuffing out. Impossible. You are bound to it, and in death it will bind you to me. That is the power my Lord Merkel has granted me. Command over the immeasurable legions of the dead. But he did not only give me power. He gave me the one thing no other god could grant me. My daughter's life returned. Her heart beating once more. For that, he asked that I serve as his chosen. Join Auron and Gortash to grow the cult of the Absolute, and then take control of it. He's never had a more devoted follower. I have fought great wars before, in the service of other gods and other powers. But for Merkel, I would condemn all of Faerun to death. You are all that stands between me and my destiny. And you have brought the prism here. I will kill you now. And then I will raise you as my servant. Yes.
Join the army of the dead, true soul. Witness Lord Merkel's glory.
My faith will protect me.
fool you are. You cannot kill me. I am eternal. Merkel, Lord of Bones, I am here. I am ready. I am yours.
life to my life. Sustain me, Clay.
Light on my feet.
What's the plan?
Ah!
impossible. Death cannot take me. I am its master. My lord, hear me. Nothing. I am forsaken. You have no idea what you've done.
The Chosen of Merkel is dead. Permanently this time. Kedrick's Netherstone. It's in his armor. Take it.
Salutations.
Action, not reaction.
My faith protects me.
No one back home will ever believe this.
In death, the body is cooling, but energy radiates from the stone.
Remarkable, truly. And now the picture comes together. The Absolute is neither God nor man. It is the Elder Brain you saw, held here by those three against its will. The crown it wears controls it, and these stones control the crown. It has been dominated. To master an Elder Brain, to subdue it. Our enemies are formidable. A temporary reprieve, but a welcome one. With a brain on its way to the city, its influence here is weakened. I believe you fought and defeated an avatar of Merkel, the god of necromancy. A remarkable feat. Ketherick was Merkel's chosen. I know Lord Enver Gortash, an arms dealer and a slaver. He is a worshipper of Bane, the god of tyranny. The other is a mystery to me, but the way she spoke, it is most likely she follows Baal, god of murder. Which means the Absolute is a front for the gods of death, and our enemies are chosen of the dead three. The crown's markings suggest it was forged in Netheril, an ancient empire whose mastery over magic rivaled that of the gods. It is a crown of domination. The stones were taken from its crest. They are Netherstones, imbued with the ability to control the wearer of the crown. The crown's Netherese magic must be the true source of the parasite's abilities. This must be what elevates their potential. And it must be the reason nobody could heal you. If the crown can do this to the parasite, I dare not imagine what it is doing to the brain. Bane, Baal, and Merkel. The tyrant, the assassin, and the necromancer. They are known to pick from their most devout followers, a chosen, granting them incredible powers. Each one alone would be a formidable enemy. But working together and controlling an elder brain, I dare not imagine what they might achieve. Hope is a luxury for those who have a choice. This is the battle of our lives, and the lives of everyone in Faerun. The army of the Absolute is marching on Baldur's Gate. Within the city, an elder brain, brimming with power, ready to turn everyone within its reach into mind flayers. All it needs is an order. An order the Death Gods Chosen are on the cusp of giving. We must wrest control of the brain from the Chosen before that happens. We must take their stones. Our chances of success are slim, but we must not fail. If we fail, everything ends. I will be your shield, but you must be the sword. And when the chance comes to strike, you must take it, for there may only be one chance.
Let's get on with it. Enough waiting. I crave blood.
one true way.
All's well that ends not as bad as it could have. What now?
Moving ahead.
Twist of its corridors, I find only more questions.
Our goal is clear, is it not? We defeat the remaining chosen and the Elder Brain they control.
Ambiguity does not come naturally to you, does it, Lazel? Your life must be far simpler for it. A wizard's quite...
I can't help but feel like I've been fumbling in the dark for too long. I've just had a lit torch thrust into my hands. The crown! The one the Elder Brain was wearing. Netherese magic. So pure, so complete, that I didn't even recognize it at first. Most Netherese artifacts contain only the faintest amount of their former power. The ghost of an echo of a memory. That crown was different. I can't fathom how such a wonder survived. Surely everything of its ilk was destroyed along with Netheril itself, but no matter. It exists. I must learn more of it. That crown sits on our gargantuan Elder Brain, bent on destroying us and everything we hold dear. Understanding its true nature might unlock the means of our victory.
We need to learn more about what we saw. An artifact as powerful as that crown must have been documented somewhere.
As luck would have it, we'll soon find ourselves near one of the finest book collections this side of Candlekeep, Sorcerer's Sundries. I need to go there and learn all I can.
Sorcerer's Sundry's is no mere trading post. It's been serving the arcane community for centuries.
Their collection of rare tomes is unparalleled.
Nether East texts are hardly commonplace, but I'm certain they'll have one or two stashed away.
You'll have to forgive my eagerness, but if my suspicions prove to hold water, this could be the answer to all our problems.
Very well.
The shadows yet fester. The dead three united under cover of darkness. The balance shifts. There are depths to this alliance yet unplumbed. Consider, mortal. Do Illithids possess souls? Thou shalt think about it now, and I shall give the answer. Mind flayers are soulless. Yet, the three amass an illithid army void of apostolic souls that could imbue them with power. A flock without souls, yet to what end, mortal? This is the question thou must come to answer. Until such time, be availed of my services. Yes, Bane, Lord of Darkness, Baal, Lord of Murder, Merkel, Lord of Bones, once judged, ascended, then vanquished, as one and as three. The Alliance is reforged, mortal. The plains thus quake, and the gods shudder. Where matters of balance are concerned, I am eternally called. No.
Goes nothing. In here.
Murder. Glorious murder. The cat ignores you, but her eyes stray to a small tunnel hidden in the wall. The message is clear. Stay if you wish, but she will flee at a moment's notice. Cat glares at you with utter hatred. You took the tadpole, its prey, and it will remember this slight.
Baldur's Gate is up ahead. No turning back once we start down that road. The psionic detector is sounding. Vlakith's warriors are upon us.
Wardaz failed to kill you. I won't make the same mistake.
Ah!
the ages. Chances.
Alerted us to the Githyanki attack. Looks like Voss was good for his word.
And you shall find me.
Can't give up now.
Corpora Sana!
Oh, I have the magic power.
What to do?
It is as we knew. My people have turned their blades against us. They will emerge from the shadows and descend from the skies, and we will grant them their only just fate. Death.
One with the weave.
ready.
For the wicked, I see.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
Never a dull moment. Catch a break.
The shadow curse still taints the land. Perhaps we could have lifted it had we tried.
Looks like an army marched through here. So much for peace.
Let's hope there's smoke powder inside.
Eyes open. Wits sharp.
Another day, another fight.
my name be known. Survival is all that matters.
Impero Tibi!
Position.
No choice but to keep going. I go from here?
Last light is no more. Lady Shah's darkness will have swept away all resistance, thanks to my sacrifice. Take a moment if you need it. I didn't know this would happen. Truly.
Give it a shot.
A bust of Kethric Thorm as he once was, a devotee of Saluna.
Time to get going.
Lost in thought.
My pleasure.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Light on my feet.
But the doctor is absent today. Come back another time.
Open up.
Ketherick is defeated. The path ahead clear. You should be elated. The sight of the land you leave behind does nothing to alleviate your sorrow. Though however deep your pain, it cannot compare to Halcyn's.
Sergeant, if you are here, I presume Wurm's Rock is secure, and preparations for my inauguration are complete.
No, Lord Gortash. We were interrupted. Another quake in the lower city. More severe this time.
So you came cowering to my chambers? I'm flattered, Sergeant. But even I cannot command natural phenomena to cease.
Forgive me, my lord, but there is panic in the streets. The people are afraid.
Perhaps the people would be calm if you kept your nerve. I expect better from the Flaming Fist than to run scared from a slight tremor in the earth. Get back to your duties.
Duties, duties, duties. Patrolling and saluting and following and bowing and scraping. Yes, sir. No, sir. Rip and cut your throat, sir.
Your plan is falling apart, Lordling. Give me a reason not to cut you to ribbons.
Control yourself, Orin. We need to focus on reuniting the stones or the brain will break free. These quakes are just the start. Neither of us expected the prism bearers to kill Ketherick. They'll be traveling to the city. Let's make sure we give them a Baldurian welcome.
I itch to peel you. To split your skin, to see your skull shine in the light. Little tyrant. Lucky for you, I harvested a whole family of living flesh in Rivington at High Sun. They will sate my blade thirst tonight. Oh, but tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow, my blades will thirst again.
Let us make camp before the sun yields to the stars.
Beyond the campsite, the city waits in uneasy silence, one sleep away.
Find a way forward. Maybe it'll bring us closer.
May the darkness protect you. Fine. What's on your mind?
How are you holding up? Don't be so modest. I can't remember the last time I met someone like you. Perhaps I never did. And never will again.
The events of the last days weigh heavily upon you. Sleep's rest is slow to come to one whose mind is so full. The Absolute is not a god, but an elder brain controlled by the Chosen of the Dead Three. They mean to use it to take control of the Sword Coast. All who carry the tadpole are governed by the brain, and by extension, the Chosen. It will take but one order to transform them into an army of mind flayers. This would have been your fate too, were it not for the astral prison, and the mysterious visitor inside of it. With her help, you have uncovered the cult for what it really is. A plan of conquest orchestrated by the gods of death themselves. Together, you have the power to thwart the Dead Three. If you follow this path to its end, the Elder Brain will not answer to the Chosen. It will answer to you. Will you liberate them from their parasites and their religious delusions? Or will you use the power you gain for your own purposes? You will not have long to wait. All you need to do now is sleep. But sleep is not for you.
Hear me.
come! Has it come?
Fight your way to the portal. I need your help.
My breath. No time for mercy.
Istavki! Morpheus!
Some healing for a wizard in need.
More are coming. Hurry, or we will all become thralls.
Your stomach drops. Your chest constricts. Your thoughts begin to splinter.
You are found. Now you hear me. Now you yield!
Thank you.
Better than nothing. Something's on my mind.
The gate is closed, as is Cazador. And we are no closer to knowing why that bastard is so obsessed with getting me back. I think we should track down my fellow Spawn. I'm not exactly looking forward to a reunion, but perhaps they'll know something. If we can find them, we can force them to tell us what he's been doing since I was gone. And honestly, I imagine they'll be coming for me in the night if I don't. Unless Cazador's changed their orders, they'll be in the dens of this town, seeking prey. We should get to them first. Then we can make their pretty tongues talk.
The absolute all is with her together will you liberate them from their parasites and their religious delusions? Or will you use your not for
they're under attack? Help me!
I am fury. I am death.
I need your help.
Thank you.
without you.
You picked the wrong fight, friend. I won't give in.
We will all become thralls. Under attack.
work to do.
Endermans breeds madness.
Nothing will stand in my way.
Hold them back alone. It's not over. Come to the skull. I need you. Now. It's not over. Come to the skull.
Against the Absolute. I must subdue him, or everything we've worked towards is lost. Don't let my form deceive you. I am the one that's been protecting you. I am the one that came to you in your dreams. Me.
a child from a viper back in the Druid's Grove. You killed the Azima Night Soul. You didn't have to. You let me live last time you were here, though it brought Blackheath's wrath upon you. Your continued existence as yourself and not a mind flayer should be all the proof you need. Now, help me.
Despite your best attempts to be subtle, the Mind Flayer's awareness is everywhere. You blunder in its presence like a walk pup learning to walk.
You must be joking. I am telling you my thoughts directly into your head. But if you insist on taking a look for yourself, be my guest.
Existence to date could have prepared you for this. As the horror subsides, you are left with only one coherent thought. You must do whatever you can to subdue the Githyanki.
Happy? Now, join me. Fight!
Against Githyanki. We cannot. We must not.
Your blind loyalty will be your undoing, Lazel. Fight with me for your own survival. Together, we can turn the tide.
protect you.
Don't look at me like that. I am a mind flayer, yes. Without me, you would be a slave to the Absolute.
It's obscene to owe my life to a damned Geih. No more lies, no more tricks. I will have answers!
It was necessary. Rare are those that would openly consider a partnership with a Mind Flayer. Even those who are on a path of becoming one. I was someone once. Someone just like you. An adventurer. I came from Baldur's Gate, though I was never one to be constrained by circumstance. I longed for more. That longing brought me to Moonrise Towers on a search for treasure. To a colony of Mind Flayers who caught me, changed me into what I am now. For years, I served the Elder Brain. The one you know as the Absolute. I was a thrall like any other, but I was fortunate. I broke free, and started a new life in my old city. I sustained myself on criminals. Unglamorous, but there are plenty of them. Rarely missed. And they fueled me when I did my work. I had the good fortune to meet Duke Stillmane. We formed a partnership, and through her, I became the governing force behind the Knights of the Shield. The largest mercantile operation in Baldur's Gate. People referred to me as the Emperor. Such was my influence. Though, of course, they had no idea what I really was. My needs were sated. I was happy for a while. Until my true nature was discovered by the tyrant himself, Lord Gortash. He tore me from my home. And brought me back to the Brain, where I became a slave once again. A slave he continued to call me Emperor. The name was intended as a slight, to remind me of the heights from which I fell. But I have grown fond of it. It encapsulates well who I've become. Prince Orpheus, son of the first leader of the Githyanki.
Orpheus,
impossible. He was slain by Justil Kithrak himself.
Quite possible, I assure you. His power has been the source of your continued protection against the voice of the Absolute. The power to disrupt hive mind communication. It is the same power that enabled Orpheus's mother to bring about the fall of the Illithid Empire eons ago. A power she passed on to him, and that I leveraged for you. When Orpheus's mother left, a usurper took her place. Vlakith declared herself queen of the Githyanki. Vlakith wanted his power, but Orpheus rose against her, and so she sealed him and his honor guard within this prism. Bound by infernal chains, Orpheus could never leave. Bound by duty, his guard never would. They were close to breaking my hold on that prince. And if they had succeeded, we would be lost. I am relieved. You have embraced your potential enough that you could help me eliminate them. Alone, Orpheus will be much easier to control. No. Gortash sent me on a mission to retrieve the Astral Prism. I was one of many, but the first to find it. How Gortash or the other Chosen learned of its existence, I do not know. The moment I found it, I felt a change. My free will returning. I followed the feeling inside, and found Orpheus. I realized what the prism was for. Containment. While my body was within the prism's bounds, my mind was free. I could resist the Elder Brain, the Chosen. Better yet, I could plan to overthrow them. All I needed to do was subdue Orpheus and find allies in the outer world. You. Most certainly Orpheus. He is a threat to her reign. Some Githyanki still revere him, in defiance of their teachings. Blackith was safe as long as they believed him to be dead. But as you can see, he is very much alive.
I don't understand. The histories claim the prince was burned to ash in the skies.
Your histories are fabrications. The prince was not killed. As you can very well see, he was imprisoned. She kept him this way because she was reluctant to eradicate such power. Power that she might one day wish to take from him. If the Githyanki ever find out what she has done, there will be civil war. Blackith will be finished. There may come a time when that is necessary. But there is no guarantee that his power would survive his passing. The risk is too great. The moment his protection is gone, he would become enthralled to the Elder Brain, just as I would. We may look different, but to the Elder Brain we are already the same. Thralls in its design. I appreciate that, but this is what I am. My original body was destroyed when I transformed. When I first escaped the Elder Brain, I searched for a new vessel. But the longer I inhabited this one, the more it grew on me. I realized that returning to my former self would only impose limitations. Any advantage I could gain by restoring my original appearance, I already had to hand in the form of magic, and that humanoid shape you've come to know. As an Illithid, I have far surpassed who I ever was before. You too should embrace this change. I believe we'll have a better chance of defeating the Elderbrain if you embrace your latent Illithid potential. I've been studying you for a while now. I believe I can trigger the next stage of your tadpole's life cycle while continuing to preserve your independence. You have seen what I can do. Imagine yourself with the same strength, the same intelligence, the same devastating beauty. If you let me, I can evolve you. The answer is twofold. One, I can, but it would kill you, as I told you before. Two, why would I? You have done well with the limited form you have, but you would do far better as an Illithid. So, do you wish to evolve or not? You will be able to do things you never thought were possible. There will be physical alterations, of course, but only partial. You will retain most of your current form, and you will soon see that the benefits outweigh any perceived loss.
Skvar! Whatever this gig offers is no gift to you.
You continue to surprise me. Your mind is truly something special. Now, hold out your hand.
Even as you say the words, you feel a lurch of disappointment. Your mind bristles with Illithid potential. How could you be so cruel as to deny yourself what you want most in the world?
I felt that. It's your nature. You cannot fight it. So embrace it. It wants to evolve, but it cannot do so alone. It must commune with another.
With excitement, its thoughts rampant and chaotic in its rush to communicate with you. It is impossible to discern any single intention.
A tadpole, nurtured by the psionic energy of the astral plane, cocooned here for millennia, it has become extraordinary.
A wave of disappointment, stronger than any you've ever felt. And then, stillness. You've resisted your Illithid instincts. For now.
You are not ready yet. Keep hold of it then, until you are. It has enough vitality to further your evolution, and your allies. Perhaps you will be more inclined to try it when you see more of what our enemy can do. But we must mustn't lose focus. We need to resume our journey. You heard the Chosen. The Brain has gone to the city, and the army marches to follow. We must not let them reach it. We must find the Brain and bring it under our control.
Time to waste. We'll see what I can learn.
There is nothing further I can do for you right now. Consider using my gift.
Of use? With haste.
We must find where Gortash and Orin have established themselves, and take their netherstones.